Welcome back to Track Talk here on Sports Radio 810 WHB and RBN, the Racing Boys Broadcasting Network. Again, I'm Scott Traylor. He's Kirk Elliott. We're the Racing Boys live from the Lucas Oil Studios here at Racing Boys HQ. Joining us on the show now is a two-time World of Outlaw champion. Man, does that sound good? Brad Sweet joins us on the show. Brad, how you doing, buddy?
Good. Yeah, thanks for having me on.
Man, how about that? You know, I was sitting there and I went back and I was just doing a little, studying before we had you on, and you're only the fifth guy to win back-to-back World of Outlaw championships. Sammy, Steve, Jason, Donnie, and yourself. That puts you in pretty good company, doesn't it, bud?
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. Kind of have to pinch yourself every now and then, especially if you're a sprint car fan like I have been my whole life. Watching those guys, never imagined that my name would be, listed in any type of category with Steve Kinzer and Sammy Swindell, Donnie Schatz, Jason Myers, and I believe Mark Kinzer has two championships. So yeah, I mean, it's pretty cool to kind of be in that list, it just also feels like there's a lot more to accomplish now.
Yeah, but going back to back, I mean, you win it last year after just trying so hard and coming so close so many times, but last year after you win it, when you come into 2020, are you extra motivated because you want to prove to everybody that you can do it back to back or do it more than once and have multiple championships? Are you driven by that at all?
Absolutely. I think once you get on top of the mountain, you don't want to get off.
Right.
Once you
yeah.
know what it's like to win a big race or win a championship, you don't want to, the feeling of losing it the next year is worse than, not getting the first one. So I think, it's definitely, there's a lot of motivation to stay on top, and we have a lot of confidence too. It kind of you can do it, you're the team to beat. So,
right.
We feel good about, everything. We struggled this year and we're still able to get the championship. So we're excited to, clean up everything for next year, hopefully get a 80 race season in and go after another points title.
Pretty intense season too, coming right down to the end of the year before you wrapped up the championship.
Yeah, nothing's like that first one with Donnie when there was only 2 points between us the last race of the year. So
that's true.
It was a little more relaxing this year, but we had a really big point lead in the mid part of the season, and we had some DNFs, just some things that were out of our control and some things that were self-inflicted, but it compounded there, and we ended up losing the point lead. So to kind of come back and then cap it off, and I think we ended up winning by 46 or
yeah, it was,
whatever
46.
Points over
yeah.
Logan, and then the team deal, we were able to win that by 20-something. So it was just one of those things where towards the end of the season, we just had to make sure that we were getting the finishes and not having any DNFs, and we were able to accomplish that, kind of get that behind us, and now we get to look forward to next year and trying to build off a few things we learned at the end of this season, and hopefully we can get more wins. Last year I felt like we, or this year I felt like we, let a few wins slip away, and it cost us a little momentum and confidence. So we want to get better at that, and hopefully we have a good solid season, and the points will take care of themselves.
Did you feel like not having the amount of races that you ran, that you normally run with the World of Outlaws? I think it was 54 races this year. Does that affect you at all as a driver? Do you need more than those 54 races? Do you feel like that kind of had you pinned up against the wall a little bit because, that you knew you were going to be running on a short season? Talk about that just a little bit.
I think when you have DNS, the shorter the season is, the more those DNFs, play a factor in the points. So,
yeah.
It's just less races. So every race is just a little more important, but it's not a normal outlaw season, and we race a lot, and that helps us get into a, momentum and a rhythm. And, mm-hmm. and it just wasn't there this year. We really had a hard time. Half the time we didn't know which track we were going to, when we were going to be racing next, just a lot of different variables that kind of, made it feel a lot different. There was no King's Royal, there was no Knoxville Nationals, just things that, mm-hmm. made it not feel as good as what an outlaw season, typically feels like. So looking forward to some normalcy, hopefully next year. You just never really know at this point, but,
right.
We're sure hoping that next year we get back on track and we get those big events back, and